It's 1 week from tomorrow night, the Great American Bash, brought to you by Castor Motor Oil, for control of WCW, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Rowdy, Roddy Piper. Start your summer off with a bang at the Great American Bash, June 13th on pay-per-view.
Back to more WCW Saturday Night here on TBS. Attention hotline fans. This past week in Los Angeles, California, surgery to the knee of Goldberg, arguably one of the hottest properties in professional wrestling. Was the surgery a success? What about the psychological scars? I will report that in detail tonight during my exclusive hotline report. Plus, it has been a very traumatic 8 days for Hulk Hogan. I'll talk about that tonight. Once again on the hotline, all of the news that is news of the wrestling world tonight at 1-900-909-9900. So sensitive we can't talk about it on the air, but you will get it tonight on the hotline. Call right now.
Thanks a lot, Gene. A week and a half ago on Thunder, we were shocked. Who was at ringside but the Ultimate Fighting Champion, Tank Abbott, who took exception with the dog-faced gremlin, Rick Steiner.
And the world's television champion, Rick Steiner, came out, and a slugfest between the two ensued on Thunder until security forces came to the scene to pull them away.
And on Nitro, Tank Abbott was there again, announcing that he would be the referee for the cage match as Rick Steiner defended the TV strap against the Stinger.
It was no holds barred. Anything goes, no disqualification. A match with stipulations that you would expect to be right up the alley of Tank Abbott.
And Tank Abbott, true to form, turned his back on the Stinger, glomming him in the back, pulling him out of the way, allowing Rick Steiner to tape the Stinger to the top rope where he was pummeled by the dog-faced gremlin.
Just the opening that Rick Steiner needed, while Tank Abbott celebrated as he left the Astrodome.
And I tell you what, like you and I, we've both known Tank Abbott for a few years in the world of the Ultimate Fighting Championship, and I'm telling you what, anybody that trusts that guy is nuts.
Why would World Championship Wrestling allow him into that steel cage to officiate a high-profile match like Sting and Rick Steiner? It was almost as if the WCW organization was asking for it. The officials of WCW thought a little bit better this past Thursday on Thunder when they ruled that Sting, Rick Steiner, and Tank Abbott would all three be barred from the building.
Good.
That was the good news. Here's the bad news.
Oh.
Sting, Tank Abbott, Rick Steiner are all expected to be at Nitro this Monday in Cleveland, Ohio. And what a month of June it's going to be for Nitro. We
Welcome
kick it off at the Convocation Center on the campus of Cleveland State this Monday. Then, June the 14th, a return to our nation's capital at the MCI Center in Washington, D.C. June the 21st, it's Nitro in New Orleans, Louisiana, at the Louisiana Superdome. And we close out the month of June at the United Center in Chicago, Illinois. The date of that Nitro will be Monday, June the 28th. Tickets are on sale right now for Cleveland, Washington, D.C., New Orleans, and Chicago at the respective arena box offices and Ticketmaster outlets.
The World Television Championship is on the line. Rick Steiner stalks his way to the ring. He puts it up for grabs with La Parka. And I'm telling you what, Rick Steiner, since reuniting with baby brother Scotty, this is a new look and a new attitude as we saw on Thunder a week and a half ago. Mike, you were there. I was there when we saw Tank Abbott. We knew something was going to break loose in that building. I had no idea it would be Rick Steiner. Rick Steiner and La Parka now.
And, of course, could we come to expect anything less from the Steiner brothers? And actually, I'm referring more to Big Papa Pump than the dog-faced gremlin. We've seen some of the tricks that Scott Steiner has pulled over the course of the past year or so. But then to see Rick Steiner and Tank Abbott, with a lot of people thinking on the surface that there was bad blood between those two. The bottom line was that Tank Abbott and Rick Steiner had some kind of a bond. And inside the confines of that steel cage Monday on Nitro, Tank Abbott attacked Sting and left the cage, allowing this man, the world's TV champion, to inflict further punishment on Sting.
I don't know why Tank Abbott did what he did. What happened between Thursday on Thunder and Monday on Nitro? These two guys were brawling, potatoing each other, tattooing each other at ringside, and then on Monday night, they're double teaming against the Stinger. Something happened over the weekend, I'm sure of it.
Well, speaking of potatoes, Rick Steiner just grabbed a side headlock on La Parka and sent him head first into that steel guardrail, follows up with a series of punches out on the floor, and now the world's TV champ brings the largest of the luchadors back into the ring.
Into the reverse chin lock. Oh, please, a forearm right across the face of La Parka for Rick Steiner. And I got to tell you, we haven't heard from the Stinger since what went down Monday night in Houston. You said earlier he was banned from the building Thursday on Thunder, as was Rick Steiner and Tank Abbott. I'm wondering what's going through the mind of Sting.
Well, I'm sure we'll find out this Monday when Nitro returns to Cleveland. Yes, we understand that Sting, Tank Abbott, and this man, the reigning world's TV champion, Rick Steiner, are all going to be a part of a huge Nitro event.
Rick Steiner just brutalizing La Parka. Oh, drops the elbow hard into the chest. Oh, one more time. This one may be academic by now. Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner, we know, Mike, they're both tremendous amateur wrestlers, All-Americans at the University of Michigan. When you put that type of talent with, look at that face, with that attitude that we see from Rick Steiner, that's doubly dangerous. I thought maybe Tank Abbott could bring them in line. No way. He's on the same side. If those three are together, what a triumvirate of terror in the Steiner boys and Tank Abbott.
Certainly a force to be reckoned with as far as the other WCW and NWO stars are concerned. Rick Steiner totally dominating this TV title defense against La Parka, not even allowing La Parka to get untracked in this matchup to get any offense, now able to reverse him into the corner. Clothesline momentarily rocked the champ, and of all things, you should not be strutting when the dog-faced gremlin is behind you. Lariat takes him down, full impact, dropping the elbow across the sternum.
Now the leg drop across the throat of La Parka. Rick and Scott Steiner were shocked like we all were a couple of weeks ago on Nitro when the Sting monster truck rolled into the building, driven by the total package. Let's go, hang on. Is that a submission maneuver? That's it.
Steps over, armbar submission applied, and you see La Parka tap out before Rick Steiner breaks his arm.
Oh, please. Just brutal. We talk about how intimidating Ming is. I'm starting to feel that way about Rick Steiner. Come on. Lashing him with that studded dog collar. Please.
Well, you can even see the intimidation factor on the face of referee Nick Patrick, who bails out to avoid having Rick Steiner take the wrath out on the official with the dog collar.
Rick Steiner running roughshod here.
Bottom line, Rick Steiner remains the world television champion.
If it's not...
I'm an American.
I'm an American. This is America.
I bleed red, white, and blue.
We're American.
I'm proud to be an American.
I'm an American.
I'm a great American.
Castrol GTX presents WCW Great American Bash. Sunday, June 13th, live and only on pay-per-view.